Welcome everyone to the very first episode of Stark Fishing. I've been wanting to do this for quite a while, and I've been looking for the right format. So when I discovered the 360-degree camera and what it can do, I thought, now this is something that not a lot of people are doing with fishing YouTube channels. So I started playing around with the camera and figured out how to edit and export, and I think I finally got to a place where I'm comfortable sharing some of my productions. If you haven't watched a 360 video before, don't forget to take your mouse, click and drag, and you should be able to look all the way around the boat and see in all directions. I'm really excited about this and how easy it will be to have friends and family fish with me, and the experience should be engaging since you'll be able to watch the video and sometimes see things I haven't seen because my back is turned. This was a really fun morning on the Savannah River below Clark's Hill Reservoir. The temperature was about 55 degrees, and the water temperature is hovering right around 60, and there was very, very little wind. Now, when the Corps of Engineers is generating, there is no telling what you'll catch. Most of the time, I'm looking for stripers and hybrids. You can often tell when they're working by the seagulls that often hang out this time of the year. Actually, if you look closely, you should see the striper surfacing close to the little boat. Sadly, on this particular day, the battery ran out of my camera, and I missed out on recording a lot of action. I caught several big hybrids and a mess of white perch, all up here by the dam. Lesson learned, make sure the camera is charged, and always have a power source in case the battery goes dead. So I'm taking my time at this point, just working my way towards that boat over there in the distance because I could see the fish were surfacing over that way. I didn't want to come up too quick, and a lot of times the stripers and the hybrids, although they're not schooling, they'll be over on that side of the river where I'm at because there's a really deep hole there. So I actually fished the entire weekend, and I even went all the way to Hilton Head, South Carolina and gathered footage there, but golly, the bite just wasn't there. It just wasn't on. I did take pictures of a couple of the stripers that I caught up there by the rope, so here they are. So I kept this little clip right here. I was on the river by myself, and watch real closely because there is a flock of birds that fly over my head, and it was just really cool. There was just hundreds and hundreds of them, and the sound is pretty amazing. You can actually hear it. So I've skipped ahead a couple days, and this is Tuesday, December 15th. It's the late afternoon, and it's been cold and windy, and I was really miserable in the morning, but I had fished all day long. I've got a buddy with me at this point. His name is John. It's the first time we've fished together, and he's not used to fishing in the area, so I wanted to put him on some fish, and we start to get into a little school of white perch.
I think this is the coldest day. What's funny is I looked at the next few days and the nighttime temperatures are going lower and the daytime temperatures are rising.
Yeah.
Isn't that weird?
There you go. This is a white perch.
Huh. Holy cow.
And they don't get very big.
Is that a keeper?
Yeah, you can keep this. Uh-huh. You scale it, fry it up, you know?
Oh, yeah.
So I'm using a drop shot rig, which is basically, I have a crappie hook that's tied on about 18 inches above a sinker. And I think this really helps with both yellow perch and white perch. It keeps that minnow up off the bottom, and I can actually throw it out and work it back towards me and come across that school. A lot of times you'll see that I'll have the bite before I even get a chance to start moving it. It's been very effective though. And John though, he's using more of a traditional sinker above the hook, and you'll see that he's having a little bit more trouble getting the fish to hook up compared to the drop shot rig.
Oh, shit.
You didn't have minnow on, did you?
I didn't have any minnow. Okay, so this is like trout fishing. You're in them and you just go, 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 huh?
Can't be, yeah.
I can do that.
It's not what I'd hope to catch, but I'll take it. I was really wanting to get into the yellow perch, but after a day like that, I'll take whatever
was so voracious
bite at the end of my line.
Very rarely do you get the hook in the side of the mouth. They swallow it like every time.
Does it matter what side of the boat I go on? Probably not.
Yeah, if you want to. So I'm casting about 15 feet that direction.
Oh, are you really? Stole my hook right. Oh, golly.
Did you miss it?
Man. Yeah, we're on it. Something here, dude.
So if I catch another one like that, we'll try to move the boat over there so that we're on top of them so you can drop down to them. Let's see what happens here. Yep.
Tell me.
Ouch.
So I'm fishing out of a 20-foot Carolina skiff, and I've only had this boat for less than a year, but man, am I enjoying it. And one of the things I really enjoy is that trolling motor. It's a Minn Kota Tarova, and I'm able to spot lock and just stick us into one spot and anchor down. And you'll see in future videos how useful that comes in, especially when I'm fishing up there right below the dam.
I'm gonna take us over there and see if we can't park right on top of them. All right?
Yeah.
Let's see. Did he take you a minute?
I do want to catch a 5-pound striper. I caught that when it was 2 1/4.
Yeah.
I don't have a minnow. No wonder I'm not getting bite. little bigger one.
That's the V-bow on this boat. It's a little different. Oh, shit.
Doubled up.
Dude.
What you got?
I don't know.
I hope it's a big old... That's a big old white perch. The biggest one so far.
Dang. Well, that's pretty exciting, Jason. Man. Wow. You're not kidding, man. Dude. Look at there. There's the tail of the minnow.
there's fire there. Hearing my wife text.
So white perch are notorious for swallowing the minnow completely. I have even tried using circle hooks and just tried to be right there. Even a circle hook doesn't work. It's somehow or another those white perch managed to get that hook all the way down into their gullet. But I've kind of learned that there's a pretty unique way of getting in there and getting that hook out. It's kind of hard to show, but you can see I'm going to do it with John to help him out. But you can't actually see what I do. But I take my finger and I kind of stick it up through the gill, being careful not to damage their gills. And I grab the tip of that hook and just turn it, and then using my finger push it out the other direction. It's kind of hard to explain, but it really works well for those hooks that get hooked a little too deep.
Let me see here. So what
he's
I have
strong.
To do, yeah, open that up, and what I'll do is come in from the side with my finger, grab that hook, and turn it, and come back out the other direction, just like that.
Well,
I got it.
I'm not sure if I'm quite cold. Some good experience.
Like a little surgery there. And if you can keep that minnow on there, it doesn't matter if they're alive or dead with white perch.
Uh-huh.
They'll eat it.
Well, that felt real good, man. I mean, he was... That was a strong bite. Like a little wolf, wasn't it? What do you say your wife was calling? You didn't have time?
Yeah, she's texting right now, but it's hard to stop to check your phone when there's fish biting.
I got a text.
I still have minnow. I don't.
How big do those perch get? Him. He chewed on my minnow.
Yeah, I think they're right below us now.
Yeah, look, he twisted that around. Does that matter?
Nope, not with white perch.
I'd say you have put us on. So there's yellow perch and white perch.
Yeah. Well, you know, crappie's basically a perch, too.
Good God, man. Well, this is just great fun. I got him in the mouth. He knew I was an amateur.
I got a guy at work that I give him the fish. If I don't want to keep him, I clean him up. Just a lot of time.
What is the status on him?
Yeah, we'll keep him. I wanted to catch a whole bunch of. I wanted to do the yellow perch, but at this point, after a day like today, I'll take whatever bites.
So we ended up catching about 15 to 20 of those little white perch, and just had a crappie, a nice sized crappie, and a couple little yellow perch. I don't know that we even kept any of those. They weren't really all that big, but not that bad. Not that bad. We had a good time. And that was John's first time. You know, he was originally, he fished most of his time down and around St. Simon's Island, and so he was kind of a saltwater fisher, and this was kind of all new to him. But he definitely enjoyed it, and we did catch a little bit of mess of fish, and I was able to give those away. But just enjoyed my time out. I think this is a pretty good first start for my YouTube channel and the 360 videos. We actually caught some more after this, and I tried a new thing. I put on a yellow crappie grub on that little crappie hook and was able to catch four or five, or maybe more, just by jigging it along the bottom. It was pretty effective.
I actually just remembered something.
What's that?
When I was maybe 19... I didn't finish school the first time, and my dad wasn't going to pay for it if I didn't get good grades. And I was partying, and so I managed to end up on the streets, as it were, having to go get an apartment and a job, 19 years old. And when I got enough money scraped together, I got a little John boat, and I think somewhere around, maybe it was a 15 horse motor. I could pick it up and put it in the back of the John boat.
Right.
And I didn't have a trailer. And I put the whole rig in the back of my Toyota. And I would go in the Saluda River in Columbia and catch white bass. Is that what I was catching? White bass?
Yeah, that's a little different than white perch.
Man.
White bass will get bigger than the white perch.
Well, this is fun. And I hadn't thought about that in a long time. But there was a night I was fishing from the bank and I caught a big
bass. All in all, a good day. So I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. And if you did, please hit the subscribe button down below and come back and join me for more videos as we kind of explore fishing from a 360 degree view. Take care. Y'all have a great day.
Oh, you did that.
Bye.